Sick, Kathy Griffin unleashes another anti-Trump attack, proves she's totally insane, deport her now. Posing for a magazine photo with a fake decapitated, bloodied Trump head just wasn't psychotic enough for Kathy Griffin. This time she went totally unhinged and compared the president to a dictator who murdered millions of people, and everyone who voted for him as psychos, reports WND. I'm going to call Trump a moron and a Nazi, Griffin said on Tuesday during an interview on the Australian talk show The Project. Americans are skittish about calling him a Nazi, but he is one. There's a Nazi in the Oval Office. Oh, please. Liberals need to come up with something new already. After almost a year in office, leftists need to come to grips with the fact that the genocide and dictatorial police state that America voted for is never going to happen. Sarcasm alert, folks. He's a big liar and everybody should get rid of him soon, she said, then added, not violently. Vote him out. Right. Antifa thugs plotting to overthrow the government on November 4th this year must wholeheartedly agree with you. These Trump folks self-identify as deplorable, she whined. They're psychos. They're nuts. I'm here to apologize. I'm sorry we have put this guy on everybody else's lap. That's right, we don't let your liberal lies get to us. We laugh when you call us deplorable, psychos and nuts, because we are actually upstanding, law-abiding citizens. It's you who are the deplorables. Griffin also accused Trump's sons of launching a full-scale assault against her, and blubbered on and on about all the death threats she received amid this scandal. After issuing a public death threat of her own, this Hollywood hack deserves to see her own mock-severed head in the mailbox. Is it actually possible that Griffin is this narcissistic, this blind to her own actions? I'm scared of the guy, she complained. I was under a 2-month federal investigation for taking a picture of a mask. I'm excommunicated from my own country doing a world tour. Scared? Griffin needs to shut up and own her actions. Her display of Trump's severed head completely traumatized his 11-year-old son, Barron. Considering the pedophilia scandals spilling out of Hollywood lately, it makes one wonder what else she's done to harm children? If only Griffin were really excommunicated from our country. Brandishing the severed head of America's leader, who else but terrorists would do such a bloodthirsty act? The law needs to come down on this fraud with the same punishment as any member of ISIS. End her career, hurl her in jail and ship her to a liberal haven outside Trump's America of her choosing.